gotta put new tracks on this machine. I got a couple of these little links that are broken here, and it was starting to split apart. I didn't notice it until somebody else was driving it, but it was like splitting apart. It's probably split apart in the bottom, you can't see it, but the other one's fine. But I'm just gonna change them both out, and then I'll keep both these as a spare since they still work.
forget to air up your track.
A little bit.
tell me how much homework you've done.
Thank you.
the project for the next few days is going to be clearing this land from here to the stream, all this going across there, and we're going to leave all the trees, anything that's like 2 inches or bigger, we'll leave that. And so we're going to clear that out. I'm going to use my grapple for that. And then we also need to take this pile and shake off all the dirt, take the stumps and put them back so we can burn them again. And then I also need to put a culvert pipe in over there so that we can access the land across there, which they've never been able to do because there's no way to really get there because there's a drainage ditch going right across here. So they have this like little bridge right here for now, but we're gonna put a culvert pipe in here and then we can get over to here. And there's a bunch of loose stumps that were dumped here from years ago when they cleared this land. I don't think there's any new stumps, but I think they're all loose, but we'll find out. And so we're gonna take these stumps and put them all the way back in the property line. So we're gonna clear this area. This is probably like a half an acre here. There's another spot right across from this little brush area right here that collects water. It's kind of a low spot. So we're gonna make a little access to it, which is also gonna be graded so that the water drains back into here and into this stream here. So that's the project that we have going on here. I brought 3 machines just because we're mostly gonna be using the skid steers, but I might need to use the excavator. So I figured rather than not have it and need it, I'll have it. And then if I don't need it, then that's fine too. So the first thing we need to do is put that culvert pipe in there. I got some crusher running in the back of the dump truck. It doesn't really need to be dug out at all because the water level right now is what it's gonna be. So what I need to do for that is actually just start with the crusher run, fill it up to the level that I need, then put the culvert pipe in, and then put more crusher on top of that. So there'd be no digging involved in that. It's a good thing I got this grapple because this is really gonna come in handy on this job. This is gonna be the star of the show right here. If I didn't have that, I'd have to use the dozer, and this is just much more convenient. got all the dirt off of all these stumps and then kind of moved them around, stacked them up again so they can burn them easier. We got this whole area cleared over here. It's not perfect, but the dirt is still really wet, so it's hard to move around. It's like a cookie dough consistency, so it's not easy to get it perfect. And there's also a lot of stumps in here. So any of the high spots have the stumps in them, which we didn't really want to get involved in that right now. But this whole area here is nice and pleasant to walk along. Got this little stream here. The stream is a little bit too deep, so it stays with water. If you guys remember on the last video, I dug this stream out a little deeper. This area here is probably like 120 feet long, maybe 60 or 70 feet wide. And that's all space that was totally unusable before. So now this is part of the field. So I cleared all the way around this like island of trees right here. And then I was going to connect it right here, but there is thousands of bees here. I don't want to get too close. Bees don't really bother me, but thousands of them do. Normally I'm not affected by bees at all. I just don't get nervous around them and they don't act up around me. But there are thousands here, so I kind of wanted to dress that up a little bit, but I can't get anywhere near there. They're going after me. Culvert is draining. It can't really drain anymore just because of the level of it. So over here, it goes around this bend right here, and then over here you got some rock, which I thought maybe I could jackhammer that up, but for about 100 feet that way it's all rock right on the surface, so it'd be at least 100 feet of jackhammering, which is not worth it. So this spot over here is again the same thing. This was totally junk before. You couldn't do anything with it. You couldn't even drive a four-wheel drive vehicle or anything. And now you could drive a car back here. And that's kind of the end of the property line. There's like a triangle. They weren't really even expecting to get past like this point, so that's all bonus stuff over there. And then we got piles of shale here. This is an old railroad here. I'm not sure if this shale has something to do with that old railroad, but there's an absolute ton of all kinds of rocks around here. This is perfect for putting in roads and stuff. There could potentially be hundreds of yards in here. This over here is not fancy. But I ran into big stumps. There's one right there. So this is as wide as I could get it. It's like 4 feet. I couldn't even drive a machine through here to smooth it out. But the idea behind this is that this whole area is always got like a foot of water after it rains. So we just wanted to drain that out and into that other stream over there, which I keep calling that a stream, but it's really a ditch. It's man-made. Well, anyways, I'm not trying to make a big deal about this job. I just wanted to get it done and show you guys the progress, because I think this is the fourth video on this property. So you can kind of see it take shape. So I'm going to get loaded up and catch you guys on the next video.